Hi guys, welcome back to another tutorial video, and today we are learning about how to add a Google form in our WordPress website, which will look something like this. And when you fill up the form, you will get an email notification which will look like this. And when replying, you can directly contact to the respondent whoever filled up the form. So if you want to learn, let's proceed with the tutorial. And before we do that, please do not forget to subscribe my channel, comment on the video below so I can create more videos for you guys. Let's move forward. Okay, now let's create our first Google form. Go to Google and search for Google Forms. Here you will see this link. Click on that. Now click on Go to Google Forms. And from this screen, you'll be able to see the already made template gallery where already forms are ready to build on. And you just need to click on any one of them to create a form. I'll click on contact information. So I'll click on that. And here we have our Google form ready to embed in our WordPress website. If you need to delete any of the field, you can simply click on that field and delete that. So I'm going to remove the comment field for now. Let's remove that. We can also add new fields by clicking on this plus icon here. So all of this, it's drag and drop. You can simply choose any file, any field method, and add in the field here. So I'm adding the field which I deleted. Here's how it will work. And from this option, you can select if the field is required or not. So if you check that, visitor will have to fill up the field to go through. And if you remove that, the field will be optional. So if someone leave it blank, form will be submitted, there will not be an issue. But if the field is required, they'll have to fill in this specific field. Okay, now let's embed this form into our WordPress website. Click on send. And here you can see we have an option. Click on there. And as you can see, we have our HTML code showing up. Now, copy this code. Now, I'll go to the WordPress dashboard and create a new page. Let's name it contact form, and from here click on this plus icon and search for HTML. Here we have option to add custom HTML, and here we can paste the code which we copied from the embed HTML section here. Let's copy it and paste it here. Now hit publish. And visit the page from the front end, that's how it looks. Here's how the form will look like. Now as you can see, there's an additional scroll bar. It's better if you remove it because it doesn't look good and it looks like it's an external form. So let's remove this. Go to the back end. And increase the height to 1100. Hit update. Go back to the front end. Hit refresh. Here we go. Our contact form scroll bar is removed now and it looks like the part of the website. We can also style it more by making it centered and changing the color from the Google form here. So let's make it same as this blue color. I'm gonna go back to the forms and click on customize theme and select any color from here. Now we have our form color as blue. Now, if I go back to the contact form and hit refresh, and here our form have blue color. We can extract the same color code and apply it here as well. Let's extract the color code by inspect element. Let's see which color we are using here. Okay, so here's the color code. Copy the color code. Go back to the forms. Add custom color. Paste our color code here. Add, and here we have our custom color showing up. And now when we go back to our form and hit refresh, the color should be matched with our website. Perfect. Looks good, right? Now let's add in the email notification feature to our Google form. And in order to do that, we will have to install an add-on in our Google form. And in order to do that, I'll click on settings. Sorry, not settings. I'll click on these three dots here. And here we can see add-ons. Click on add-ons. That's the screen you will see once you click on add-on. Now let's find for email notification add-on. Here we go. This is the add-on which we need to install. Click on it. Click on install. Click on continue. Now it will prompt for the permission access, because it's an external add-on and we will have to allow the certain features in order to make it work. Click on allow. Okay, our add-on has been installed now. Let's go back. Okay, it's showing up twice. Let's cancel this one. It's already installed. As we can see, uninstall button now. Close this screen. And now we are seeing the add-on option here where we can set up our add-ons. Now let's do that. Email notification for Google Forms. Now I'll click on create email notification. And mention the rule name as email notification 1.0, just email notification. Here we can add in email addresses to notify. We can add in multiple email addresses by separating it from comma. And I'll add in just one email for now. Sender's email. Let's make it same as this one. We can, okay. Sender's name, contact information from website. Reply to address, we can add in a dynamic field. So whoever will fill up the form and add in the email here, this dynamic field will pull up the value from this field. So this variable will pull up the value from this field. For example, if I am filling up the form and I'm adding an email here like WebSensePro or WebSensePro123@gmail.com, Google will automatically put in that value in this field. So I'll just need to hit reply and I can directly contact the recipient of that form. Okay, now hit save role. And we are good to go. Our rule is saved. Now let's go back to our website and do the test submission. Hit refresh first to make sure it's pulling up the right Google form, updated Google form. There we go. Now I'm gonna test it by test name one, test@gmail.com, testing address for Google form 123123, testing comment, and hit submit. Okay, our contact info has been submitted. Now let's check it on our email if we have received an email notification. That's the only one. Refresh. Here we go. We just got the response from our Google form. Success! Yep. So in this tutorial, we successfully added Google form in our WordPress website and added an email notification feature. There are a ton of other features in Google form. For example, we can record all these entries in spreadsheet. We can further add in a webhook to process the data for any other application. And it's a great tool which we can use in our web application and our website. So I hope you guys like the tutorial. Feel free to let me know in the comments if you need to learn anything more related to website designing, web development, and custom web development. Also, we are providing social media marketing and custom website development through our agency. So if you are willing to create a custom website or doing social media marketing for your business, feel free to comment below. I'll contact you from there. Have a great day.